It's 10%. It's 4%. Where x equals the number of believers, and if x equals 457,962, then 85% equals 389,207.70. This is astounding.
Professor.
Professor. Thank you for coming so early this morning. I wanted to tell you about my latest discovery. You've heard of the 1040 window, right?
Yes, of course. It's right here.
It's a geographical opportunity to share the gospel. And now, I have discovered a new window of opportunity! No, it's not on the map! This window of opportunity is not based on geography! It's based on age groups! It's called the 414 window! Four. 14. Allow me to explain, beginning with a simple scientific illustration. Just as we break down the entire spectrum of electromagnetic radiation into usable categories, such as sound waves, radio waves, and light waves, I have broken down the entire spectrum of those who accept Jesus Christ into age categories. Using statistical methods of analysis, I calculated the percentages for each age group at which people accept Jesus Christ as Savior. Notice the 4 to 14 age group. In many places, up to 85% of the people who accept Jesus Christ as Savior do so between the ages of 4 and 14. This is a new window of opportunity to grow our churches and impact our communities and other people groups.
Children? We have Sunday school for the children.
You can verify this yourself. Ask any group of believers how many of you accepted Jesus Christ as Savior between the ages of 4 and 14. More than half of them will raise their hands.
The children play Bible games.
Children deserve more than programs that just keep them occupied while the adults are having church. In more than 1,500 verses, God underscores his love for children, how he uses them for his purposes, and the importance of ministering to and becoming like children in our hearts.
We let the children invite their friends.
No! The old ways are not enough. This discovery necessitates rethinking everything. We think ministry to adults produces the most results. Actually, children are more responsive to the gospel than adults. In fact, the moral course of a child is set before he or she reaches 9 years of age. Think of it. Discipling our future leaders before they have anything to unlearn. After this, everything involves undoing and unlearning. Pastors and evangelists focus mostly on adults. Why not focus on those most receptive and able to change and grow? Missiologists reach out to adults in different ethnic and religious groups. Why not reach people when they are at the age when they are most receptive? And why can't our seminaries help them do it? is the new E equals MC squared, where E is evangelism, M is ministry, and C is children. Evangelism and everything that follows is accomplished through ministry to and by children.
But this changes everything.
Yes.
It means formulating new paradigms.
Yes.
New worldviews.
Yes.
New mission strategies. New theologies.
Yes.
Nothing less than total academic and theological transformation.
Yes. And you're just the man to do it.
Yes. I am.
I found it. This is it. The 414 window.
I need to discover at least two more things before breakfast.